Hi there. In today's video, I will briefly go over the SCAN function in Excel, how to use it, when it is useful, and how is it useful for running totals. Now, the SCAN function is a relatively new function in Excel. It came out in early 2024. A quick way to see if you do have the SCAN function in Excel is if you start typing in the SCAN function, it should automatically come up as a usable function. If it doesn't, it hasn't been installed in your version of Excel yet. So the SCAN function is very useful when you are looking at a series of numbers or an array of numbers, and particularly useful when you are trying to calculate running totals. Prior to the SCAN function, you'd have to make manual formulas that adds up each of these numbers. If you wanted to, let's say, calculate a running total for this sample test data here that we have, some sales data for these folks. You would have to do things like, so you're going to take this number here, you're going to add this number plus this number. Okay. Now for the next one, you're going to have to go equals this plus this, right? And so on and so on. So it's a little bit complex if you were going to do that. The SCAN function allows you to look at an array and write a function or a formula, and it will actually populate the entire result in a single row without you having to have a formula in each of the cells. The SCAN function utilizes the Lambda function within it, which I will go over briefly as I create the SCAN function for you. The Lambda function is simply a function in Excel, which allows you to create a custom function using Excel's programming language without venturing into the Visual Basic or any type of coding like that. I will get into that briefly, as I said, when I explain the SCAN function. So let's say I wanted to show the cumulative result from these prices here, or from these sales that these folks have made. You will do that by using the SCAN function. So I will go equals SCAN to open up the formula, or the function rather. So the initial value, if I'm looking to show running total, the initial value is going to be zero. The array or series of values that I'm going to be looking at would essentially be these figures here. And the function that I'm going to be using is that Lambda function, which I've just briefly explained previously. Lambda. Lambda allows you to create a function within a function, essentially. So I'm going to call out the parameters of this Lambda function by using the variables at the beginning. So you can call the variables anything you want. Typically, you'd use X and Y. So we have X and Y as the variables within this Lambda function. And then I'm going to just tell it what I want the function to do, which is add these two together, X plus Y. It will close the Lambda and then close the SCAN. And you will see it automatically populates the cumulative totals down this row. So 119 is 5950 plus 5950. 178.50 is these three added together, and so on and so on. If you wanted to test it, you could do a sum at the bottom. You could add up all these, and then you see the 1379.20 at the end, and the same thing with the SCAN function. Another useful example for the SCAN function would be, let's say you wanted to keep track of a running total of the coldest temperatures in this example data set here. You would use very similar syntax for this SCAN function. SCAN, the initial value. So this time the initial value, instead of it being zero, it's going to be this 25. So I will just click that cell. The array, again, is these numbers that we're evaluating. And this time the function is going to be that Lambda, and you're going to call out your variables, which is X and Y. They could be named anything you want. Let's use A and B this time. Now, I want to know the minimum temperature in this array. So I'm going to use min A phi. And then you close all of your brackets. And you will see it gives kind of a cumulative running total, but of the minimum temperature. So it's 25 here. It's the first one. Then it goes down to 22, which is correct. 19. Then it drops to 17, but then it goes up back up to 25, but it will keep the 17 running down the total because it is the minimum temperature out of all of these numbers. You'll see then it drops to 12, so then it puts it to 12, back up to 17, but it will remain at 12 because it holds the minimum number. That is a brief explanation of the scan function and the Lambda function. For more advice, check out spreadsheetpoint.com and don't forget to like and subscribe.